Hello, welcome to the other Better Worse in my channel. Today we're going to look at the Maze Runner book versus movie. Yes, indeed. It's time for another young adult novel or whatever it's called in English being adapted into a movie, basically. And how well are they doing? Well, let's compare them. Topic number one are going to be storyline. Storyline is relatively the same. Our lead Thomas is basically ending up in a maze that is changing overnight, and so on. He ends up, well, the part of the maze there he actually ends up basically called the Glade or something similar to that. He meets up with a group of boys that basically have been there for at least 2 years, some of them, and some have been, of course, there less time. Every month another boy is basically given to them from a shaft that is having an elevator that brings a boy, some resources, and so on. But when Thomas basically ends up in the Glade, some different things have started to happen. The maze are, well, becoming weirder and weirder. Some of the boys have been stung by, I think they're called cleavers in English, by some of the cleavers, which are basically, well, cyborgs, if you can call it that. They have living tissue, but at the same time, they are robots. I don't know what to call them, basically. When you're all stung around, you're basically getting crazy. Here comes the big first difference between the book and the movie. In the movie, it is the girl Teresa that comes with a cure for this. Well, cure. It is basically, well, helps them to, well, okay, it's like a cure, but during this cure they get their memories back, because when they come to the Glade they don't have any memories. In the book, they already had this serum, or whatever it's called, cure, and Teresa doesn't give it to them. That is one of the big differences in the beginning. Teresa is basically the first girl that I've been in the Glade forever, and well, when she is basically the last one, and that is the same in both the movie and the book. What isn't different, but the thing that is different is that in the book she basically ends up in a coma, or a coma, I think it's called in English as well. In the movie, if I remember correctly, that doesn't happen. Well, maybe it would have taken up more time, but anyway, that is the way. And they're going on and going on. They're trying to get out of the maze because it is starting to get weirder and weirder. And during one night, the maze basically doesn't close their doors that they do at the night, which basically makes them vulnerable for the cleavers that are out there in the maze. So they are trying to find out a way out of there, and they find a way, which is a little bit different in both the book and the movie. In the movie, it is basically a hole in the wall, they found out later on. What I understand in the book is that it is a hole that they, in a invisible force field or something like that, that they jump into. In the movie, they basically run through a hole in the wall, but anyway. And so on, they get out, bad things happen, and it's the end. The big difference in the end, in the book and the movie, which is a big spoiler, is that in the book, what is called Gally, or what something similar, which is have been against Thomas throughout the book and the movie. In the book, he is basically, it turns out that he is basically manipulate evil corporation that they call which is called the Wicked, which you will get more information about in later books. But they are basically controlling his mind, which they find out that... I think it is later in all the books, I can't remember exactly, but... He is basically being controlled by the Wicked, and he is trying to kill Thomas. But his friend that he met at the first day, which is called Chuck, basically saves Thomas but dies at the in the process. In the movie, he just went all out crazy, and that is it. And in both books and the movie, the rebels are basically coming and get them and just get take them out of there. And that is how it ends. When it comes to the storyline, both are really great, in my opinion, but the one that stands out the most and actually have more consistent and great storyline is the book. As I said, it has a more consistent storytelling, and when it comes to actually telling the story, they are actually more fully fleshed out. It is more believable than the movie, in my opinion. Topic number two are going to be effects and environments. Effects and environments, because it is a book versus a movie, it will be a little bit different. But what I have said in the review about Maze Runner, it is that it had a very small budget compared to other big movies nowadays. Around 30 million, which is a really small number when you compare them to the Hunger Games and Divergent series. And it looks amazing, all the effects and environments they have in that movie. The environments in the book are really well explained and everything, so when it comes to this story, it's going to be a tie because of that. But overall, I think the movie has, when it comes to effects, it is amazing what they have done for a small budget. But the book stands out because they explain a lot more and have a more interesting take on the environments, in my opinion. Topic number three are going to be, well, what can we take? The maze, why not? I think it is well explained and everything in both book and movie, but when it comes to the maze, the big difference from the book and the movie is that in the book, they are underground. The maze are underground. In the movie, they are at the surface, which breaks some big twists from the book, but they didn't end up in the movie, so why not? In the book, it feels more, a lot bigger, the maze, than it does in the movie. In the movie, it seems more like they are in a small, well, it isn't that small, but it seems that they are in a smaller place. But when it comes to the movie, it actually more fun to watch when it comes to the maze, when read about it. It feels a lot bigger in the movie than it does in the book, and it actually feels more, what do you say, it feels more epic in the movie. So the winner of this topic is going to be Maze Runner the movie. And the final topic number four, I'm going to be characters. The movie have less characters, that is the main thing I can say. Of course, there are some differences what happens with all the characters and which ones that actually ends up having some roles between them. The big difference that I can see is that there are a group of leaders, well, what do you call them? Yeah, I call them leaders, especially in the book, that they talk a lot more about, and they have different roles in the glade, and that is more fun to read about, and to have more characters to actually care about is actually more interesting than in the movie. In the movie we have the main characters, of course, but then they have cut down the amount of characters that you actually see in the movie or you read about in the book. You maybe have 10 against maybe 20 people. That is basically half of the book character, so. But when it comes to how I like the characters in both mediums, they're somewhat the same. Even though you can basically say that in the movie, all the characters are more likable. They aren't as big of assholes as they are in the book. But even if that's the case, the winner of this topic are going to be Maze Runner, the book. Reason for that, as I say, they doesn't feel... even if they feel more like assholes in the book, it is more of a great storytelling when it comes to the characters. When they have more characters to care about and more characters to actually, well, read about and see for yourself in your head, it is more interesting when you watch maybe 10 characters that you can get a little bit tired of sometimes. So yeah. And overall, the ultimate winner are going to be the book. Reason for that is that even if the movie is really good, in my opinion, the book stands out the most because it has more characters to care about. The effects, environment, or well, the explaining of environments are amazing. The storytelling are more fun to follow, even though it doesn't have as big of an impact when it comes of the maze. It still stands out the most out of these two mediums. And that's all for today, folks. Talk to you next time. Bye.